But first, watching the UK election coverage today, I couldn't help but wonder if it's provided Australia with a glimpse of what's to come at the next federal election. The war in Gaza was a huge issue in the UK election, where voters on the left and in Muslim communities expressed anger about Labor's delay in demanding a ceasefire. And our colleagues at Sky UK today explained how the Labor vote was low in areas of high Muslim populations.
Here you can see, essentially, we're showing you different parts, different Labour constituencies ranked in terms of the Muslim populations. So from more people who are Muslim through to lower Muslim populations. And just look, in lower Muslim population areas, the Labour vote's going up. So up 3.4%. But look, as you move into areas with higher Muslim populations, you're talking about big falls, really big falls.
Yeah, the difference is pretty striking, and it's a trend across the UK in different areas and regions depending on the Muslim population. It shows a significant proportion of that community is unhappy with policy on the Middle East conflict. And I believe it has given us a clear sign that Australia is about to follow suit. Rogue Senator Fatima Payman has unwittingly become the new face of the Muslim political movement in this country. And as she quit Labor yesterday to sit on the crossbench, what she didn't say was most telling.
At this stage, I do not plan to form a party and, you know, we'll stay tuned.
Stay tuned. In other words, more to come. Her resignation would only embolden the Greens and a new political movement, the Muslim Vote, a new campaign group which is planning on launching a Till-style assault on Labor seats in Western Sydney. And it's got the PM worried.
I don't think and don't want Australia to go down the road of faith-based political parties, because what that will do is undermine social cohesion.
It would be a disaster for the PM if the new hero of the community, Fatima Payman, joins harnessing their anger. The Muslim Vote claims it is powerful enough to sway the outcome of the next federal election. It's already drawn up a list of Labor seats it plans to target in Western Sydney. Now, I spoke earlier in the week about the Muslim Vote group over in the UK, which aimed to mobilise Muslim voters to vote against MPs who have not backed a ceasefire. It has, according to today's results, been largely successful. Now this movement has reached our shores. The Muslim Vote is running on a pro-Palestine platform, meaning sectarianism has landed in our backyard. We are a free country, but this is concerning, and Peter Dutton agrees.
When you say that your task is to, as a first order of priority, to support a Palestinian cause or a cause outside of Australia, that is a very different scenario. So I think when that is the main cause, we have all sorts of problems.
Political parties who are there to represent one faith, one group, one set of views over the broad swaths of Australians is a recipe for disaster and social division. The UK has today provided us with a glimpse of what is to come, especially in the event of a Labor minority where its policies will be shaped by a mixture of groups who probably won't put Australia first. And what Fatima Payman does next will undoubtedly shape those policies.